Surrounded by pop stars trying to act tough. I got an activist on me, niggas.
And I
hold up. They said that we couldn't smoke in this building. We fucked around and still rolled up.
I'm on a new level. I'm on a new level. I'm on a new level. I'm on a new level.
All right, gentlemen, we've reached the co-main event of the evening. We're going for 3 fives for the title. We went over the rules in the back. Do I have any questions from the blue corner? Any from the red corner? If you'd like to, touch gloves. All right, let's fight.
Co-main event, the Ace Fighting Championships bantamweight title. And Tony, this could get a little confusing because we've got Tony Laramie in the cage. I've got Tony Carvalho up here with me. Ryan Donnelly, the champion, with a massive size advantage at 6'3" or just around that neighborhood. Tony Laramie comes into this fight, though, at 4-0, and he is explosive.
Yeah, he's got the big tree trunk legs. He certainly has got a lot of power there.
Whoa, Laramie with a bit of a slip there as he spun backwards. And you talk about having two camps behind you, Misha Cirkunov and Dennis Pirich on one side. I saw Kyle Prepelec and TJ Laramie on the other side. As Donnelly dances to the outside, trying to use that tremendous reach advantage.
He's doing a good job. He's actually trying to keep his distance and trying to land his shots properly. So he's doing a good job, but Laramie certainly is ducking in, getting into his own distance and trying to land his big winging punches. And there's the big punch.
Tony Laramie chops away to the body and scrambles up to the top. Laramie battering away, drops Donnelly down.
Done.
It's over. It's over. The stoppage of this fight comes at 1:03 of the very first round. Your winner by TKO due to referee stoppage and moving to 5-0. And now the Ace Fighting Championship bantamweight champion, Tony Laramie! Well, we'll start off here. I know this isn't the way you wanted this to go, Ryan, but Ryan Donnelly, who was the 135-pound champion, a great fighter here at Ace Fighting Championship. Ryan, what happened in that first round?
You know what? I think I just got a little overwhelmed at first. I still thought I was okay. I was defending. I thought I was going to try and burn him out. Like, I was getting to my feet, but, you know, at amateur, fighter safety comes first. I applaud the ref for his decision, and congrats to Tony.
Ryan, you've remained classy throughout everything in your amateur MMA career. You do so again tonight, even in a loss, my friend. You can still hold your head high as a champion. Tremendous effort on your part. We hope to see you again at Ace Fighting Championship.
I'll always be back. I'll never quit.
Thank you, Ryan Donnelley. All right, if I can get through the crowd here. For the new champion at 135 pounds in Ace Fighting, my goodness gracious, Tony Laramie. And Tony, I've heard about you and your brother TJ for years. Your coach Reno told me moments ago you're going to be the best in the world. Now, this is a tremendous first step to that goal. You're now 5-0. How does it feel to be the champion?
Right off the bat, I would like to thank Street Soldier for supporting my brother and I. And it feels good. Thank you for all coming today. And on June 11th, you'll see me again, even though I'm fighting June 4th.
Well, we have to see you again. You've got our belt. That was a tremendous fight on your part. Before we let you go, though, I got to know, there was a tremendous size disadvantage. How did you break it down to get inside and be able to get that finish?
I did what I do best, head movement, and hit hard. When I train with a little bigger people, and no one's my size, so I'm kind of used to it. But then since he's a little lankier, I just expected less powerful shots. That's about it, yeah.
Tony Laramie, you're the new champion. Congratulations, my friend. Tremendous fight.
Follow me on Twitter, at Tony Laramie, and Instagram. And stay tuned to watch me fight again. Have a good day.
He had my arm hooked, and I'm not trying to pull away from that. There's no chance. Tony Laramie, the new 135-pound champion of Ace Fighting Championships. Now, folks, at this time, I would like to call on a UFC veteran. We've talked to two of the special guest fighters tonight. Well, we saved the biggest one for last. I want to know whose idea was to put the 5'8 guy in the cage with UFC light heavyweight Misha Cirkunov. And Misha, if we could get you for a couple of moments up into the cage. At 11-2 professional record. Now, the last time you and I did an interview, you were fighting Martin Desolay. You've gone a long way since then after you blasted through him. Congratulations on making it to the UFC and all your success so far. Let's start off with, when can fans see you next?
I'm fighting, my next fight is actually in Canada, Ottawa, June 18th. I'm training very hard. I'm taking it very serious. For those of you that are planning to show up there and support, I guarantee you it's going to be a very, very exciting fight. And I'm going to be looking to finish my opponent like I always try to do in all my fights.
Now, Misha, we've asked the other competitors tonight and the other UFC fighters what they think of a promotion like Ace Fighting Championship and the opportunity it gives to young fighters. What do you think about this promotion?
I mean, can you believe this is an amateur show? I mean, the way it's ran, it's a pro show and the great fights. I mean, that last fight, did you guys see that? Like, the power in those hands, those are 135ers, and they throwing, like, you know, harder shots than some pro guys that I've seen. So, I mean, great fights, amazing performances, and just, you know, I'm excited to be here.
Finally, Misha, I know a lot of fans in Canada especially know how great you've been throughout your career, an 11-2 pro record. There's only, it seems, one place for you to go. The world is talking about John Jones and Dan Cormier and Alexander Gustafsson. I would personally like to put Misha Cirkunov into that category. The UFC light heavyweight title, a couple more wins. What do you think?
You know, I've always been that guy that, you know, like I said, I'll fight anybody. And, you know, Joe Silva, whoever he puts in, and, you know, they give me, I'm fighting this guy. So I just, yes, I'm available, and let's make it happen. I don't want to say, oh, I want to fight this guy. I believe I'm here and here. I show it in my fights, and then when people want to see me fight, you know, top 10 or top 5, and I'll be ready. You know, I'm training very hard, and I'm always working on my weaknesses, and just excited to be, you know, representing Canada right now.
Misha, I don't know if you remember, but the last thing I'm going to talk to you about is before you fought Martin Desolay, do you remember what you told me in the interview before? I said, what are you going to do in this fight? You looked at me kind of like you're looking at me now and said, I will break him. Are we going to see that June 18th?
You know, June 18th, you basically, I don't know if you watched my fights before, but, you know, I try to finish all my fights, and, you know, that's exactly what I'm going to be trying to do on June 18th. You know, it's very hard to predict exactly what's going to happen in a fight, just like in the last one, you know. I thought, you know, we're going to keep it standing up. Next thing you know, we're on the ground, and, you know, there's a submission. So I don't plan how I'm going to finish people. I just work on all the aspects of the game, and whatever the fight goes, you know, I'll try to finish it there.
Thank you very much, Misha Cirkunov. Ladies and gentlemen, that is a UFC fighter, an 11-2 record, one of the baddest men on the planet. Thank you very much, Misha.